exceptions, I gather, you don't become a law student, I should retract it. And that worries me, because my impression was, you don't wake up early one morning, decide I'm gonna be a law student, got into. Sorry, I'm just saying, because I believe that I learned that the nexus between trafficking and prostitution is stronger than I thought. I was led to believe that prostitution, more or less, was something popped up one day, became prostitute, not something that you were led into surreptitiously as a minor or even as an adult. It was a very good learning situation.
I was so thankful that I was able to attend this. I really learned so much. I took so many notes. I think they were talking about, and I'll add to what David said, that a lot of people that go into prostitution are abused as children, and they just head that direction. The other thing was Lisa Thompson, who's the vice president for Washington, D.C., came up, and then the doctor from Rhode Island, Dr. Hughes, gave us examples of all kinds of different ways you can decriminalize just parts of it. Like, they talked, you talked about the Nordic model, which really helps the victims. It pushes on more on the pimps, to come up with another word, and it also the buyers. It'll affect them more criminally, but it will give alternatives to the people that are in prostitution. For instance, rehabilitation, and there were so many facts given of things that had worked and things that hadn't worked that I really had never seen before, and I was just amazed at the total number. And these people are professionals. This is what they do for a living. I mean, they know what they're talking about, you know. So it was really eye-opening to me.